Hi everybody, thank you for joining me for today's live lesson. My name is Sian, there's my name, and I will be with you for the next 30 minutes, more or less, for a grammar lesson. Today's lesson, we're looking at how to tell stories and what tenses you need to use to tell a story in the past. Doesn't need to be a big, long story. It could just be something interesting that happened or what you did at the weekend. If you're joining me today on the 12th of January at 1:30, then you're with me live. So welcome. Send me messages so I can see you and respond. And if you're joining me in the future, that's also great. You can still send messages and join in with all of the tasks. So say hi, everybody. Let me know where you are and what you're doing today. And let's have a little question to get started. So, do you like swimming in the sea? Why or why not? So send me a message in the comments and let me know. And also don't forget to tell me where you are and, well, I'll see your name. So hopefully I can say hi to some people. All right. So hi, lots of people coming through. So hi, Romino. Thank you. Welcome. Hi, Erica from Switzerland. Thank you for joining us. Hi, Juan from Peru. Hi, Manuel. Good to see you again too, Manuel. And, oh, it's moving so quickly. One more. We have Raf Sanur from Bangladesh. So thank you, everybody, for joining me. So let me know, do you like swimming in the sea? Why or why not? And tell me in the comments. Oh, I can see a few. Jessica, it's fun and relaxing. Absolutely. I agree. Maybe in the UK at the moment, it's not very relaxing because the temperature is freezing. But I agree. Normally, it's fun and relaxing. So I feel the same. I love swimming in the sea, but I have one small problem. Oh, the currents. Ah, where do you live? Yeah, that can be a problem. I used to live in New Zealand and there were some really dangerous riptides. That is definitely a problem. I have one more problem with the sea. These things. What do we call these in English? Can you let me know in the comments? What is that in English? I have a problem with these in the sea also. Send me a message. Lots of comments coming through. Oh, I like swimming. Yeah, okay. Merka has said what these are. Jellyfish, exactly. That's my only problem. I love swimming in the sea, but my problem is the jellyfish. Right, so here's a little story about swimming in the sea. I'll make it a bit smaller so you can hopefully see it. Let me know if the text is too small and I can make it bigger, but hopefully it's okay. So at the moment, all the verbs are just in their infinitive form. This is a story from the past, so a few years ago. Can you put the verbs into the correct form? So you can do one at a time or all of them in one comment. And if you don't want to send a comment, you could just write on a piece of paper and find out if you're correct afterwards. So what's the first one? I swim. How do we change swim? What verb form do we need? So I swim in the sea. When I feel a sharp pain, ow, I look down and see that I swim through a group of jellyfish. Here are jellyfish. So can you tell me what we need to do to these verbs? Okay, we've got a few coming through. First one from Bismarck. I was swimming. Oh, you've given us all the answers. Felt, looked, saw, and was swimming. Okay. Does everybody agree? Or do you think any of them need to change? I was swimming when I felt a sharp pain. Very good. I was swimming when I felt. Very good. Wow. You're all writing so much. You're very fast at typing. I swam. Okay, so lots of different answers coming through. I was swimming. Okay. Thank you, everybody. Keep sending your messages. Lots of good answers. So here's the first one. So have a look. I was swimming. We'll look at why in a minute. But I was swimming in the sea when I... Correct. So lots of people had this first sentence correct. I was swimming in the sea when I felt. So feel, past, felt. So be careful with irregular verbs here. I was swimming in the sea when I felt a sharp pain. Okay, so a few people have put, I swam in the sea when I felt a sharp pain. Don't worry, we're going to have a look at why in a minute. Okay. Looking at all your answers, there's lots of good answers, but I think the problem is with the last one. So stay and check, because I think a lot of people are making mistakes with the final one. So let's have a look. So I was swimming in the sea when I felt a sharp pain. Number three, look, what do we do here? Nate? Correct. I looked down and what's next? I looked down, here we go. Kazakov? You are correct also, well done. I looked down and saw. Now this is the one people have made a few mistakes with. What do we do here? I looked down and I saw that I, how do we change swim? Hi, Judah Cott from, wow, fantastic. Thank you for joining us. Ty, oh, yep, saw, correct. Sada, I looked down and saw that I was swimming. This is actually possible. It changes the story a little bit. Does anyone know another option? Aha, Gabriella. Almost. Very close. We just need to change one letter. Does anyone know what letter we need to change here? But very, very close. I swam. Okay, another option. Swum. Lots of different options. Very good, everybody. Okay. Sorry, the comments are coming so quickly. You're all doing really, really well. Okay, the last one. I looked down and saw that I had swum. So careful that you sound, not ah. So swim in the past, swam, and the past participle is swum. Okay, so I looked down and saw that I had swum through a group of jellyfish. Oh, interesting. Sanda, have I lost your comment? One second. I may have lost your comment, Sanda, I think it was. But yes, you are correct. You could also have had been swimming. It changes it slightly, but they are also possible. Okay. What's a past participle? So, Michael, to make perfect tenses, so present perfect or past perfect, we use the third form. So for example, swim, swam, and then swum is the third form. It's called the past participle. So I have swum today. I had swum. Don't worry if you're not entirely sure. You can look up past participles in dictionaries or online. So if you're not sure, don't worry. Ah, JJ, what's a jellyfish? Don't worry, you may have missed the beginning of the lesson. I will show you. That is a jellyfish. Okay, that is a jellyfish. Okay, so let's move on and have a look at why. So let's look at the grammar. This, so here we have three different forms. We have the past simple in this story, the past continuous, and the past perfect. Don't worry if you're not clear about the names of tenses. We will be looking at that and we'll be doing lots of practice. In this story, which form are most of the verbs in? Is it the past continuous, the past simple, or the past perfect? So looking at my story here, what are most of the verbs in? So let me know in the comments. Lots of people are saying, what does jellyfish mean? Okay, I'm not going to go back to the picture now, but it's a creature with lots of tentacles in the sea, and it can sting you and it hurts. This story is true for me. If you're not sure, go back later to the beginning of the lesson and you'll see a picture. All right, lots of people are giving the answer. Past simple, yes. And that is important to remember, okay? When you tell a story, most verbs are in the past simple. Okay. But we also have two other forms. So, looking at this story, which action in the story, which verb sets the scene? So, which one introduces the story? Which verb or which tense? You can tell me either. So, is it the past simple, the past continuous, or the past perfect? Yes, Akilesh, hopefully I've pronounced that correctly. You are right. Okay, so the past simple is the one we use for most of the actions that happen. But I said, which action introduces and sets the scene? That is the past continuous. I was swimming in the sea. Okay. I was living in Italy at the time when this happened. Okay. Which past action in this story happened before another one or before some other ones? So, which action in my story here happened before the other ones? So let me know in the comments. Is it the, we've got some answers coming in already. Past perfect? Yes, exactly. English ate my life. that's good. So yes, past perfect. Lots of people are saying past perfect. Very good. So let's have a look. I had swum. This happens before. Don't worry if you're not sure. We're going to have a look now in more detail. So, first, the past continuous. So, we use this to set the scene. For example, I was living in Italy. I was swimming in the sea. And we also use it if you have a long action interrupted by a shorter one. Have a look and we'll find out a bit more. I was swimming in the sea when I felt a sharp pain. So there are two verbs here. Number one, I was swimming. Number two, I felt a sharp pain. So if I'm going to put this onto my timeline, so here I have a timeline. I've got the past, and then I've got now and the future. So let's have a look. Number one, so I was swimming. It's an action, it's continuing. Where does number two go? Have a think in your mind. Where would you put number two? I felt a pain. Before number one, after, future? Okay, here it interrupts. I was swimming in the sea and I felt a pain. So, you can use this for lots of different examples. I was walking home and I got a phone call. I was snowboarding when I broke my arm. This is also true. So, I think I have lots of accidents. But yes, we can use it for lots of different interrupted actions. And then, looking quickly at the form, so we have the subject. Was or were, and then the ing form of the verb. So that's the past continuous. Careful with pronunciation. So was, when we're talking quickly, becomes was. So repeat after me. Say was. I was swimming. I was swimming. And then were becomes, oops, sorry. We were swimming. We were swimming. So try saying w, w. We were swimming. Have a practice. Don't feel embarrassed about talking at home on your own. I'm doing it now. So just have a go and try practicing it. All right. Now, past perfect. This is the one I think people had a few more difficulties with. So past perfect shows an past action happened before another past action. And you could also use it to talk about things that happened before the main story. So let's look at a little timeline again. So here are all my different verbs. Let me just move my name. We don't need my name anymore. Hopefully you know me. I'm Sian. If you've just joined, thank you for watching. We're looking at tenses to tell stories in the past. Okay, so number two, verb two, I felt a sharp pain. Number three, I looked down. Number four, sorry, you can't see that very well, but four, I saw. And then five, I had swum. So let's put them on our timeline. So number two, I felt a pain. Number three, so it happens next, I looked down. Number four, I saw. Now, where does number five go? Let me know in the comments, where shall we put number five? Does it go after four? Does it go before two? Does it go in the middle? Let me know in the comments. I'm going to say a hi to a few more people. So sometimes sort. Yeah, there are different accents. Sort for me, I would say I saw. Saw. So there's no R sound for my accent, but there may be different accents where the R is more pronounced. But yeah, good question. I would just say I saw, or. Okay, so some people are saying before two, ahead of two, before everything. Lots of different ways to say the same thing. You're correct. So number five goes before. So I swam through the jellyfish before I felt the pain, before I looked down, and before I saw. So this is why we use the past perfect. All right. Just to make the past perfect, we use the subject. So I, he, she, etc. You always have had. It doesn't change. It's always had. And then the past participle. Some people might call it verb three. It's the third form of a verb. I had swum. We had eaten. She had written. Okay. Let's have some practice. And then we'll find out if you are all using it correctly. Let me know if you have any questions. Hopefully I'll see them. And we'll move on to some practice. So I want you to start telling me a story now. So here's the first word and here's a picture. So can you write for me the first line of my story? What can we say? I'll have some water while you're writing line one of our little story. Remember, it's the first line, so we are setting the scene. So what tense do you need to use? The sun, let me know. Lots of people. We have got Jessica, the sun was shining. It's quite tricky to say. Stacy, the sun was shining. Careful with spelling. Just one N, but very good, Stacey. Some people are saying the sun was shining. Yeah, I've seen a few comments saying the sun was rising. That's also possible. Yeah. So in the morning, the sun rises and then it sets. Excellent. The sun was setting. Lovely. These stories are far more romantic. The sun was setting. I like that. I think I might change my story. I have the sun was shining, okay? But I also like the sun was rising and the sun was setting. They are also good. The important thing is to remember it's the beginning, we're setting the scene. So the present continuous helps set the scene for what's happening. Okay, so we have line one, the sun was shining. What's next? So I. Here's a little picture to help you. The sun was shining, so I, what did I do? Send me, write it down in the comments. The sun was shining, so I, okay. We've got lots of different answers. They're moving fast. So the sun was shining, so, So I started jogging in the park. Yeah, that works very well. So Tawicha, I went for a jog. Very nice. The sun was shining. So I went to, yeah, careful with prepositions. So I went for a morning walk, but I like that. That's good. I went for a morning walk. I'm having problems with my pronunciation today. So the sun was shining. So I went jogging. Yeah, I like that too. The sun was shining. So a few people have got present. Remember, this story is in the past. So we can't say the sun was shining, so I run or I'm running, because this is all a past story. I run in the park. Again, yeah, ran. Yeah. I went. I took a walk. Yeah, that works well. Okay, lots of different ideas. So the sun was shining. Let's put this one. I went for a jog. So this is the past. Okay, this is the main action of your story now. So the sun was shining, so I went for a jog. Or I run. Or you could say I went jogging. I went running. All right, let's do the next sentence. While, So we need a sentence here. What happened? Can you make a sentence beginning with while? So the sun was shining, so I went for a jog. While, Hopefully you can include two verbs here. Have a think. Lots of people are also saying, I went for a walk. That's also correct. And some people are saying completely different things. I decided to work in the garden. Yes. Doesn't follow the picture, but it's a lovely sentence. I like it. Okay, so while... Okay, this is nice. So, Kanemozi. Hopefully I've pronounced that okay. While I was jogging, I fell down. I will change only one thing here. This is a really nice sentence. And the grammar is very good. The grammar is very good. But I would change, while I was jogging, I fell over. Down we use for things like I fell down a mountain or I fell down the stairs. Okay, I fell down something. If you are walking or running and you fall on the floor, we use the phrasal verb fall over. But the grammar of your sentence was perfect. So we have a long action while I was jogging, and it's interrupted by a short one in the past. While I was jogging, I fell over. Very good. Thanks for all your comments. Lots and lots of really good ideas. Oh, this is nice. While I was running, I slipped on the road. Excellent. Really good. While I was jogging, yes, again, fell over, not down, but very good. While I was jogging, I, yep, again, very good, but fell, F-E-L-L, very good. While I was running, lots of people are saying fell down. I think it makes sense. It's logical to say I fell down, but we use the verb fall over if you're on a flat surface. Okay. So what happened next? So while I was jogging, I fell over. I turned round and saw. Okay, can you finish the story for me? What's the final sentence of this story? Have a think about when this action happened. So while I was jogging, I fell over. Then I turned round. So we've got the past here. I turned round and saw. What did I see? Okay, let's see if we have any answers. Whoa, so many answers for the last picture. Ah, very nice. I saw a banana, peel, P-E-E-L. Very good. Or we call it generally banana skin. So very good. Hi, Michael. Yeah, lovely example. Very good example of the grammar. I saw a banana. Okay, very good. Quick question here. One second. Someone is, here's a question. Shakil, what's the difference between while and when? We use while for the longer actions. Okay, so while I was running, I fell over. Okay. When I fell over, I hurt my leg. So if it's a continuous action, you use while. While I was running, while I was swimming. But if it's a short action, just use when. Okay, so I turned round and what did I see? Oh, okay. Lots of people are using the... Okay, this works. I saw a banana skin was lying on the ground. There's no problem with this. This is totally unrelated to the banana, but this is also a very good sentence. I turned around and saw that I hadn't done up my shoelaces. Very good. Let's look at one more and then you can see my final answer. Let's see if anyone has the same as me. Oh, this is good. Someone had thrown a banana skin or peel. I slipped. Okay, nice vocabulary, but let's have a look at the grammar here. So this is a good vocabulary. Yes, you have the same answer as me. Oops, sorry. So I turned round and I saw that I had slipped on a banana skin. So remember, the slip happened before I fell over and before I turned around. So this is why we use the past perfect here. I had slipped. And just be careful with pronunciation. When you're talking, we don't say had, really. You don't say, I saw I had slipped on a banana skin. We contract it. So we say, I'd. So when I turned around, I saw I'd slipped on a banana skin. Very good. Lots of other answers were correct, but just be careful. This happened before, so we need to make sure it's the past perfect. Okay. Have you, little question to finish, have you ever hurt yourself? So we have me getting stung. I've broken my arm while I was snowboarding. I've never fallen on a banana skin yet, but what about you? Have you ever had a little accident where you hurt yourself or you got stung or bitten? Send me a little comment. We have a few minutes left and let me know what happened. It doesn't need to be a very long story. It can just be one sentence, but send me a message, what happened, and let's see if we can share a few. Salam, what's the difference? I had and I did. I did would be the past simple, okay? Whereas I had, we use with the past perfect in these examples, okay? Had is the past of have, or we use it for the past perfect. Okay. Let's have a look at a few accidents. But rub banana skin on your face to make it shine. I never knew that. Everybody now will be at home rubbing banana skin. I've run out of bananas. I can't try this. Okay, let's have a look at some accidents. Once I slipped in the bathroom and cut my lips. Oh, that's painful. That's very painful. Were you having a shower at the time? So I was having a shower. I cut my hand when I was, yeah. Okay, I was going to say good. This is not good. I'm sorry you cut your hand, but a good example. So here we can use while. So I cut my hand while I was cooking. Very good. What else? Any other accidents? While I was crossing the street, a car hit me. Oh, God, that sounds horrible. What happened? Were you hurt? Were you okay? Wow. A dumbbell. So fell on my head. That sounds really painful. Oh, lots of accidents. I'm sorry we're finishing on such a negative note, but really good examples, everybody. I fell over. So I slipped over on a hill. Yes. Lots of good examples. Duyan, I misplaced my foot and fell down the stairs. Oh, that sounds painful too. I burnt my hand when I was taking something out of the oven. Yes, that's also a really common problem. Let's have one more. When I was young, I was riding a bike and I hit my head. Okay, so you banged your head. Oh, so many dangerous problems. I slipped. Yeah, here we don't need to use the past perfect because this happens in order. So I slipped while I was walking on the street. Okay, I slipped while I was walking on the street. Before I forget, we're about to finish, but we have a worksheet. You'll be able to find it in the comments, the link to the worksheet, and also in the text above or below this video. And there's lots more practice. So there's a gap fill where you can fill in the past perfect, the past continuous in a story. And then there's an activity where you can write your own. In fact, here it is. So look out for this comment. Practice all these tenses and more by downloading the worksheet. Okay, thank you very much for joining me. Thanks for all your wonderful comments and your stories. I'm sorry for all of your injuries and for reminding you of all these injuries, but thank you for sharing. And I'll see you all again very soon. Have a lovely rest of the week, and thank you very much.